Hello, I'm Ayelet Cano, and I'm the president of Manual Therapy Seminars, and this is our friend and colleague, Gleb. If you could just tell us a little bit first about where you work, what sort of practice, and how you're integrating IMT into that practice.
I'm working with back-to-health outpatient physical therapy. It's an orthopedic, primarily, physical therapy office. We spent pretty significant time one-on-one with the patient, and with my personal practice, even though like from my schooling and everything, I'm like more maintenance trained and more classical physical therapy trained, I found that with the IMT, I'm not only can treat symptoms, but also tap into the reason for that. That's actually helping me to extend the quality and results that we're providing for the patients.
Now, you had an interesting introduction to IMT because you had spent some time with one of our very dear colleagues and friends, David Barenbaum, in New Jersey. And so what was it about that that got you to be so interested in IMT before you had, you know, clinical skills?
Basically, seeing the results, seeing the ability to drastically change, even from spending one time with the patient, drastically change the outcome of the patients, even though at certain points I was the patient in David's office, because with the problem that I was not able to solve, or other professionals that I was looking towards was not able to tackle or change.
We've all been patients, that's for sure. So, you know, let's imagine that there is someone here that is considering studying integrative manual therapy. They haven't quite committed to it yet. Do you have any thoughts, words of wisdom to them on why you think it'd be a good thing for them to study, why it's so valuable to you?
You're definitely going to be able to bring a good change. And something that David taught me, that if somebody came into you, you can help them, but with the IMT, you're going to be able to do way better than you're able to do it now. And it's definitely like not that we're not going to call it panacea, but it's like it's such a strong tool in your toolbox that you can use and apply. Because for me, even like I have pretty basic skill, but sometimes when I'm like hitting the rock bottom, I cannot do the change. I'm like, I tried everything I knew. Let's go for IMT. And here's like that click. The patient stands up, and like even I'm still shocked with that. Like, okay, it worked. Why didn't I do it from the beginning?
Now, you've taken classes a little out of order because you've sort of taken what's been available in this sort of newer evolution of courses. Any advice to the learner that is going into a class and maybe it's a little overwhelming because it's a lot of advanced material and they're just sort of getting their feet wet? Any suggestions?
Try to find the compassionate practitioner that will be patient enough to help you to digest
a mentor.
All the basically a mentor, because you need to digest, like your body have to adapt. Like I see, the more practice, the more clearer, the more normal is it becoming for me, and the way like you can perform, because definitely that takes time, that takes practice, that there takes patience. And that's another huge advice, like you have to be patient. Because it's not going to work from the beginning.
Fair enough. And as I said before, we've all been patients. We've also all had mentors. It's incredibly important for all of us to gain our skills that way by observing and working in tandem with someone. So that's great. Thank you so much, Gleb, for helping us with this video testimonial.